spoke things into existence. So there is the ability of God in you that can speak things into existence. Witches and wizards, they can be wicked on the outside, but on the inside of them, there is a likeness of God that gives them the ability to create things around them. What witches are using is the likeness of God. God said, let us create men in our own likeness. No matter how wicked they are, but there is still the likeness of God in them. No matter how your child will become weak, there is still your blood that is there. There is still the likeness of you on the inside of that child. So they can be wicked, but they know that I have the likeness of God, that I can go anywhere I want. I can enter any place I want. But you as a child of God, you don't understand. So until you learn to operate in the supernatural, you will remain in the natural. The natural is temporal, but the supernatural is permanent. Adam was in the atmosphere of the supernatural, where he could speak to animals. Can you speak to an animal now? No. Why? Because you are in the natural. When Daniel was thrown in the lion's den, the supernatural appeared and spoke to the lions, and the lion calmed down. Are we together? So now here we see Jesus in the morning. He saw a fig tree. As he saw a fig tree, he expected something good there. He expected the fruit out of that tree. But the Bible says what he saw afar off was the leaves. What he saw afar off, he saw the leaves. So as he saw the leaves, he knew that if I go close, there is something that I must get. He went there and said, perhaps whether I will get it or I will not. This is Jesus. This is God that we are seeing here going there. So how can God stand there and expect a fig tree to supply for him without commanding the fig tree to supply? Because Jesus has the power to say, fig tree, bring out fruits, I want to come and eat. The fig tree can do it. But now, this time Jesus was there, looking at the fig tree, expecting something. When he came closer, there was nothing. How many times have you seen something, a business that you thought, this time I've made it? When you come closer, it is empty. So now, as a child of God, I want you to understand what Jesus was trying to do there. He was allowing the situation to decide the results. He said, let me allow the fig tree to decide the results that will give to me today. Let the fig tree decide what kind of a result to give to me. It's like you enter that job and say, I'm working here. Let the job decide the salary to be given to me. The job will decide for you. Your hard work will speak for you. And the salary will be increased. Because the job has decided that, no, you can't earn 5, you must earn 10, or you must earn 20. Are we together? So now, at a distance, he saw the leaves. He was expecting something. So which means, there are things that you see from far, they are godly. But when you come close to them, they look somehow. Are we together? So Jesus was teaching us to say, don't look at the leaves and get too excited. You must look for the fruits and you know that something will come out. Sometimes we see a leaf, and then you say, no, this job I'll get a good salary. But when you are inside, there is no fruit. How many times have you found yourself in a situation that you thought that situation will supply for you, but that situation is just a fig tree with leaves, no fruits? Jesus was angry when he got there. Jesus was angry. Nature was working against him. Is it not Jesus that was speaking with nature? Is it not Jesus that commanded the sea and came down? Let there be peace, and there was peace. But this time around, the fig tree, I'll show you. So now, why was the fig tree doing what it was doing? And why was Jesus angry at the fig tree? Hence, when he was going, he said, I will get the fruits, or I might not get the fruits. When you came out of your house, we received a call that there is a job interview somewhere. They say someone just come for an interview. So when you are going for that interview, you know they might take me, they might not take me. So if they did not take you, why are you angry? Because you heard too that they might take me or they might not take me. So why are you taking it bad when you are not being taken? Huh? Sometimes you get angry because you are rejected, but you don't know. Have you found God in that situation? What is God saying about this situation? What is God saying about my rejection? Maybe you were rejected for a reason. If you entered that company, you were not going to last. But you cry to fight yourself to enter there. So now, don't look at a form of godliness from far without seeing a fruit. Are we together? There is once Jesus said, every tree you see, a good tree brings out good fruits. And a bad tree brings out bad fruits. And now Jesus tend to say, you shall see them by what? Their fruits. Not by their leaves, but by what? Their fruits. There must be a fruit that is seen in you as a child of God. What fruit do they see in you? Do they see the leaves or do they see the fruit in you? Are we together? Jesus, he found nothing but the leaves. But he was expecting something. Whatever that he was expecting, he never found. Give me Genesis chapter 3, verse number 7. These are what? He found what? Fig leaves. He found what? Talk to me. The leaves of what? Of a fig tree. Okay. The eyes of both of them were what? And they knew that they were what? And they sought what? They did what? Together and made. This is the first Adam. When the covering that was covering them, the covering from God left them, the fig tree came and said, let me cover you. The fig tree stood at the garden as the covering of Adam and Eve after they've sinned. So the fig tree stood as a covering in the supernatural world. So the fig tree said, if I can survive in the supernatural world, you Jesus as the second Adam, I can cover you as well. Look at verse 14. The Bible says Jesus responded. Is it verse 14 or verse 20? It said Jesus responded. Who was he responding to? Who was he responding to? Okay, let's look for that, Pastor Dumi. Is it verse? I don't know. Now, the replacement of the covering of God in the garden was what? the fig tree. It was what replaced the covering of God after Adam and Eve sinned. Now look at what say. Okay, let's go to, okay. In response, Jesus said, who was he responding to? Because when he came, he saw a fig tree, expecting fruits. So who was Jesus responding to in verse 14? Did anyone speak to Jesus? No. No one spoke to Jesus, but he was responding to someone. So which means when he came to the tree began to speak to him. Don't you see you are naked? Let me be your covering. So why did Jesus end up kissing the tree? Because the tree was likening Jesus with the man that was cursed. Now the Bible says, listen, Jesus responding and said, why was he responding? The tree spoke, you are coming to me and let me be your covering. The same way I covered the first Adam, let me cover you. Because when I covered him, he was naked. So it's because you are hungry, you are naked. Let me cover you up. Every time you become frustrated, you become naked in the sight of the enemy. Every time you are frustrated in the sight of the devil, you become naked. And that's the time they are using to fight you. Now Jesus responded. He said, because you are likening me with the cursed man, I'm cursing you today. Do unto others what you like them to do to you. You see, Jesus, because you like me to be cursed, I pronounce a curse over your life. He spoke over that fig tree. He said, from today, no one, because if I leave you, you will deceive someone that will come after me. So from today, try. No one shall eat of you again. Because you are likening me, you want to cover me, you don't know that I am God. Nature was standing against Jesus. Nature was resisting Jesus. So there are situations that will test you to see how connected to God you are. There are challenges that will test your faith. Nature will test you to see how connected to God are you. So now, that situation was there to make you understand. Now, Jesus was saying, you must have faith so that you can deal with the mountain. So before you deal with the mountain, you must deal with the fig tree. Because remember, if you don't deal with the fig tree very well, the mountain is watching. And the mountain will resist you. So if you are not dealing with the fig tree, you will not stand against the mountain. You will not command the mountain to move. So if your faith cannot deal with a leaky fig tree, your faith cannot move the mountain. There are situations that you have failed to deal, but you are fighting, you are running for the bigger ones. They will bring you down. There is a level of failure that will come upon you that will not allow you to be victorious in some territories. There are territories that you enter according to a victory. They will ask you, what did you do? David said, I've killed what? A bear. He had something that he did that will is a key that will allow him to enter that level. So what have you done? Which battle have you won? That when you want to shift to another dimension, you say, this is what I've done. Allow me to enter. I can do more. You have done nothing. The level of fight that you fight will determine the dimension that will be permitted to operate in. How many battles you have won will determine the dimension that will be unlocked for you. Now, the Bible says, in the morning, I'm trying to rush this thing. In the morning, when they passed, Jesus took them that way so that he will know, they will see what is happening. But as they were passing, one of the disciples was saying, Rabbi, come, see the fig tree that you cursed, it has dried up. But he did not know that Jesus was there to teach them, to show them that when you speak today, when you wake up tomorrow, you must see the result of what you have spoken. Are we together? After you finish praying, you must see the results of the prayer that you have prayed. The people that you will meet after praying, they will confirm the prayer that you have prayed. The people that you will meet after the time of prayer will confirm what? Your results that you received in that time of prayer. Are we together? So it's all about speaking into the atmosphere. An atmosphere was created by speaking. He spoke to that fig tree and it dried up. So today, any situation that is resisting you, any situation that is rising up against you, that says you will not increase in this year, in the name of Jesus, in the name that is above every name, we speak over them now and we command them to dry up in the name of Jesus. We speak to every situation, we command it to dry up now in the name of Jesus. We command that situation to dry up now in the name of Jesus. So I want you to understand, as a child of God, Jesus was teaching them a principle after saying, you must see. You must say and see the result. Are we together? So as a child of God, desire to operate in the supernatural. Are we together? Desire to operate where? So, the situation you see today becomes attached to the words that you spoke yesterday. Some of you speak bad things into the atmosphere, and when the atmosphere resists you tomorrow, you don't know that is the words that you created and you placed in the atmosphere. You planted them, and now they are standing against you. So always speak positive, because the devil will always use the strategy that he once used before to bring you down. So don't allow what happened to those that before you to happen to you. Don't allow the same situation, the same strategy for the devil to be continue using it on your head. Are we together? Speak over the situation. Speak over every situation you see around you. Are we together? Today, we open the realm of the supernatural. When you pray, you must unlock that realm. Enter into that realm. And you begin to speak from that realm. In the realm of the supernatural, anything that is impossible becomes possible. Because even Jesus, as he was walking, he was saying that there are leaves. But because he was in a realm whereby this thing must bring. But the Bible says, there were disciples around him. One of them was supposed to tell him that, Master, it is not the season for these things. So Jesus is not operating in season. In season, out of season, he can still bless you. Are we together? So the power of words, create a word. Every morning you wake up, create a word in the atmosphere. Say something in the atmosphere. He said, whosoever says, whosoever, it doesn't matter who you are, anyone that says to this mountain, speak and say something. Are we together? Speak and say something. For you to move that mountain, deal with that fig tree. Are we together? So if you want to move the mountain, the Bible says you must be ready to say something, and you must believe in what you are saying. You must be ready to say something, utter words, and you believe in the words that you have said. Some of us, we are killed because we don't believe in what we say. Are we together? Because of time, let's rise upon our feet. Trying to cover this thing because our time is being swallowed up. But are you blessed in this short second? Are you blessed in this short second? Did you learn something? Did you learn something? Please, I want you to understand that God wants us to operate in the realm of the supernatural. That's why in this month of January, we will deal with the supernatural. So that when you understand the supernatural, when you enter this other month, it is easy for you to increase because you are in the realm of the supernatural. When you are in the realm of the supernatural, you believe anything that is possible. No matter how difficult the situation is, you still believe that you will come out. Are we together? So I want you to lift up your voice and I want you to pray. I want you to lift up your voice and I want you to pray. Grace, the anointing to operate in the supernatural this year. Father, release it upon me tonight. Father, release it upon me tonight. Lift up your voice and begin to pray. Lift up your voice and begin to pray. Lift up your voice and begin to pray. The realm of the supernatural, open it upon us. The realm of the supernatural. La pashata kapalaba. Yeshalabalaba yanda. Kunda kete balu shate balabaya. Shanta kupala zuta labahande. Manda labalabalabaya. Shakula balekada balakusha. Ligata palapalabaya. Endo shata payando sadabalaba. Era pashanta la kapaya. In the name of Jesus. The realm of the supernatural. Hey, Shaya Labayada. Rapa Shanta Laba. That realm where Elijah operated. The realm of the supernatural. Father, open it upon me today. In the name of Jesus. I want to operate in that realm in 2022. Palabalabalabaya. Shata Lakabaya. Lato Parate Shatabaya. In the name of Jesus. We bless your name, Lord. Father, do it for us. Lift up your voice and talk to God. Let that realm be open for you. Let that realm be open for you. Let that realm be open for you. Realm of the supernatural. Allah Pashanta Lekopaya. In the name of Jesus, the realm of the supernatural, the realm of the supernatural, let it open upon us, let it open upon us, in the name of Jesus. Father, do something new in our lives. Unda katuta palaba shanta. In the name of Jesus. Father, we bless your name. We glorify you, Lord. We magnify you, Lord. In the name of Jesus, we give all the praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Listen, I don't know the situation that has presented itself like a fig tree before you. That situation that has come before you and presented itself like a fig tree, I want you to speak against it today. Use your mouth to speak against that situation. You know what you're going through. I want you to speak over that fig tree, over that situation that presents itself like a fig tree over your life, over your family. I want you to speak against it. I want you to speak. If you want it to be destroyed, let it be destroyed. If you want it to be scattered, scatter it right now. Use these 2 minutes. Speak over that situation right now. Speak over that situation right now. You know what you are going through? You know the fig tree that you are facing. That situation that presented itself. Oh, Ladabalaba Shanda. Kenda Sutabele de Bahande. Shadabalabalabalabalabalabaya. Konda Satupalakete de Kopalabaya. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Shapala palapalata. Tandala balabayande. Oshatu tapa tu shatapa. Alaba shantanama. We command every situation to triumph now. Every situation that represents a fig tree in the life of your people, we command it to triumph. 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 In the name of Jesus. Thank you, King of Kings. Thank you, Lord of Lords. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, we pray. In Jesus' name, we pray. Lift up your hands. Father, we bless your name. Father, for everyone that is present here today, I decree and I declare over their lives, let every form of fig tree that has presented them itself in their life, let it dry up now in the name of Jesus. Let it dry up now in the name of Jesus. Father, from today, I pray in the name of Jesus, the anointing not to fail, let it fall upon your people right now. In the mighty name of Jesus. Every spirit of limitation, every spirit of failure, we come against you in the mighty name of Jesus. We release the anointing of God upon each and everyone that is here. Let your life be transformed. Let your destiny be changed. In the name of Jesus. I impart you with grace. The grace to change. The grace to increase. The grace to move with speed. In the name of Jesus. Any area where you were disappointed, oh Payata, we cancel disappointment today in the name of Jesus. We cancel disappointment in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we give you praise. We bless your name. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Please, because of time, let's close. Because of time, we're supposed to be closed by now. But because of time, let's close. Let's meet on Sunday. The hand of the supernatural. Are we together? The what? The hand of the supernatural. That's the service of Sunday. Let the hand of the supernatural be released upon you for you to operate in the supernatural. Are we together? Please, be ready. Don't eat on Sunday. Those that are eating in the morning, this Sunday, don't eat. Come fasting, because on Monday, we are starting our fasting. So, Monday, you eat after service on Sunday, don't worry. But don't eat this Sunday. Let the hand of the supernatural come upon you, so that when you begin to fast, you are in the realm of the supernatural. You begin to understand the fasting. Are we together? So please, be connected. And I believe I will talk about the fasting for 10 minutes on that Sunday, so that we understand how the devil will come to fight us, to stop us from fasting. Are we together? So please, invite someone on Sunday. Don't come alone, and the Lord will bless you. Please, if you are having your seat offering, rush quickly to come and drop it. Rush quickly, come and drop it in the name of Jesus. If come forward, drop your seat offering as we close. Come forward, drop your seat offering as we close. In the name of Jesus. Labadabaladabashanta.
Shatabalabada. Yaladabaya, Yaladabada.
Right. May God bless every hand that has given in Jesus' name. And please, I want you to prepare for the service of the 23rd of January. Are we together? Listen, God will wipe away your tears. God will wipe away your tears. Your story will change. You must come on Sunday. God will do something new in your life. He will make you smile. 2022, things will change in the name of Jesus. Listen, on the 23rd of January, we have a service that we take it Supernatural Encounter, Angelic Visitation. Are we together? All of us, we are encouraged to wear all white. Let there be angels in this place. Are we together? Even Kateko will be wearing white, playing keyboard there. Even I don't have all white. I have to look for one as well. So we wear all what? White. 23 January. Angelic what? Supernatural encounter. So prepare yourself for 23 what? January. Yeah. So scratch your head like category.